I am glad y'all are here. We have, well, this is episode 154 of HDVR. That's Hot Dog Vendor Radio. And we've got some questions already. We'll be answering more questions during the show. All you have to do is put in the comments, and I'll try to get everybody's questions as I go. I'm excited to be here. We do have some news. Some news. We have Vendor of the Week this week. The Wiener Queen Concessions and Catering. Wiener Queen Concessions and Catering. I like that name. That is awesome. And if you want to see them, they'll have. We're gonna start pinning the Vendor of the Week at the top of our page right here. We're gonna pin it during the week. You know, till each Thursday. So thank you, Wiener Queen Concessions and Catering. She says, I had a rough start, but found some great locations and now kicking butt, microbreweries. All right. You can find them on Facebook here too. We'll have a link to that as well. I'd like to say hey to Martin, John, thanks for being here. Chris Kastner's in the house. And, let's see, Martin, John, Chris Kastner, Dustin Smith's here. Thanks for being here, James. Oh, my gosh. James in the house. Randall's in the house. Robbie Miller's here. Thank y'all for being here. I appreciate it. Let me get to the first question. If y'all have any questions, feel free. I don't know if you saw the video I did this week. I got a call. It wasn't a live video. I posted it up, though. It's down below here somewhere, maybe five or six posts ago. And it's so I got a call this week about a – said, if this business is so good or so star spangled good, why ain't everybody doing it? And so, it was fun. Hey, Bill, glad you're here. DL Turner, thanks. James here. Michael's here. Mark Payne's here. Awesome. Thank y'all for being here. Glad you're here with us. So, here's the deal. I was going to tell you something. I don't know if y'all saw me yesterday. I got online and was doing a live broadcast and showing y'all something freaking awesome that everybody can do in all 50 states. It's a hot dog slider, basically. It's a slider, but it's a hot dog. And you can boil it, steam it, grill it. It is freaking awesome. All beef. Tastes delicious. I've tested them now for 3 or 4 days and tried them different ways and cooked them different ways, overboiled them even, tried them, boiled them without dirty water. You know, I didn't sauce up my water first, tried them every way I could. And, they didn't come apart. They didn't nothing. They're freaking fantastic. Hey, Greg's in the house. Glad Greg's here. Anthony's here. Carl Baker's here. Bill Moore's here. I thank y'all for being here. And also, you know, anyway, let me tell you what happened. Plenty of battery on my phone, plenty. And I'm going, oh, we're good to go. I'm going to film this and, you know, go live. And I show y'all, I had made some up already. Everything was going deliciously. I go outside and show you the grill, flipping them, turning them. Then I'm going to go into the whole thing about them. Okay. Tell you how to get them, where to get them, everything about it. Right. And my phone dies. My freaking phone dies. As soon as I plug it in, it says 41%. Well, that's magic. So take it in. Had to get a new battery is the bottom line. That's at least what they told me. So got a new battery. Mary, glad you're with us. So I am going to put a link up, but I'm going to still do another video. And tomorrow is my plan. Tomorrow I'm going to do another video and start over from scratch because it's worth it. I'm not connected with this company at all. I found them and it blew my noggin. Wait till you see these. You're just going to love them. Okay. So, El Kenny's in the house. Dave's here. Glad y'all are here. Anyway, be expecting that tomorrow. And if you aren't able to catch it live, don't worry about it because you can still watch it. We're going to put it on the blog and everything like that. So you'll be good to go. Now, first question, We're sitting here with my boys, awesome guys. We have a tad of an argument. No one is too mad. We are just having a good time with the boys. Our ballpark hot dogs at Fenway, are they grilled, boiled, or steamed? Well, from everything that I could research, okay, with the power of the googly, I came up with that they serve steamed dogs, and they actually have a Fenway dog that they have made, okay? From what everything I found, it's steamed dogs. So that was the answer there. Then it said, same with gas station dogs, grilled, boiled, or steamed. And I said, none of the above. Because gas station dogs, typically, unless it's got a deli in it, and they then they could be deep frying their dogs for you. They could do anything they want. But most gas stations, even big truck stops, they got them on rollers. Okay. Roller, roller, roller. Okay. Light heat, just roll them. Now, so that answered that question. Next question. Do you know of a good place to get some good chicken dogs for a great price? Good chicken dogs. That's like an oxymoron, I think. Chicken dogs. I'm just kidding. My wife loves chicken pecker and beak dogs. I swear to you, she does. Throw in feet, just cram it all in there. She likes it. She likes the packs that say byproduct. So anyway, you can get those chicken dogs. Typically, the cheapest place I've found, typically your cheapest dogs are chicken dogs. Okay. And beef byproducts and pig byproduct dogs. Those are typically found at like Save-A-Lot grocery stores, your discount grocery stores. Dollar General has a grocery store. They have some cheap ones there. Any type of discount grocery store. There's one in our next county over that's just a local no-name type of grocery store. They sell a quarter pound dog that's freaking delicious. It's huge. It's real short, but it's huge. So, you can go to those kinds of places, discount grocery stores. You can find those. Next question. Oh, let me check. I'm waiting on my order from Hopped and Brewed. Got two bottles of meat sauce, honey Q and regular Q. Can't wait. Guess what? That Hopped and Brewed, I've been trying it on other stuff, Mark. It is freaking fantastic. It is unbelievable. That stuff is just delicious. Greg, thank you. Thank you. And Greg, just by the way, I know I have a WhatsApp message from you. I haven't listened to you yet, but I saw the announcement come across my screen a little bit ago or a little while ago. Have you ever tried Snap Dogs from New York City? Robbie, I haven't tried Snap Dogs. I know lately, because we've got a vendor that's Snap Dogs got a good footing in New York, I believe it is. And they're doing pretty good. And they put their name on the dog. They brand the casing. So it says Snap Dog. Pretty cool. I haven't tried them yet. But I have no idea. You know, it's like me telling you that Boar's Head is really good. Well, it ain't good to some people. Some people are like, I don't like it. So it's like opinions and buttholes. Everybody's got them. And so I don't know. But I'm willing to try it. I'm willing to try Snap Dogs. I saw an interview with the manager online. I looked it up. I YouTubed him. And I thought he had a cool deal. He's got different vendors taking over, and he's branding it to vendors. So I think it's cool. It says I'm there, but no voice. Refresh your page. Just refresh. Should be working. I know some people are. John says, no video or sound. Who can see me right now and hear me? Can I get some thumbs ups or something? Chris says I am. James is here. John's here. Robbie's here. Let's see. John Berger's here. DL. Yep. Heather says no video and sound. Working good here, Chris says. Who knows? I do not know. I know some people. Anyway, let me get to the next question. if you got a question, remember you can put it in right down below and I'll try to get to it. Let's see. Is there ever a worry about people? This is a good question. Is there ever a worry about people with allergies eating from your cart? We're about to open and just popped into my brain. Should I post any signs? I've heard of vendors selling stuff that, like, there's a vendor out in Oregon, okay? And he puts a peanut something. He puts that he has products made with peanuts, could have touched peanuts. A peanut could have been near at some point and got near his hot dog stuff. He's got a sauce, some kind of peanut sauce. Anyway, it's kind of an Asian fusion dog. Okay, so it's got a peanut thing going. Anyway, it's a good question. I don't know if I'd worry about it. Like, I mean, which allergies are you going to call out? Please tell us if you have any allergies. And, well, that'd freak out regular people. What do you mean? Like all allergies? Gluten allergies? Peanut allergies? Steam table allergies? Allergies to helping me get rich? I mean, which kind of allergies? So, I don't know. I don't have a clue. I probably would not. I can tell you this. I've never put a sign like that on my cart. The only signs I have on my cart say, don't touch hot. You know, that keeps little kids, maybe their moms at least, from letting them, you know, go up there and grab a hold of the grill or something. So I'm not sure if I would put that up. You've got your other signs up. You don't want other signs competing with your signs. You know, you don't want too much signage going on that is unrelated to making you money. If somebody with a bad allergy, a peanut allergy, they might walk up and go, hey, it's not like your peanut sauce is going to run, you know, jump on them. Just say, you know, that typically somebody with allergies, hey, does this have, you know, is this made from grass-fed beef? You know, I don't know. Yeah, that DL says most people with food allergies will ask you. DL just got done, and he's been in the restaurant business for years. And DL, tell me, did y'all have any signs about allergies in the restaurant? Bill says he's got work allergies. In saying the raw food issue, I don't know. I don't have a clue. So I don't know. I wouldn't do it. I wouldn't put up the sign. I'd carry insurance. I'd have my liability insurance, but that's it. That's all I would do. I think that's all I got for you. I think that's it. I did all that in 12 minutes. That is like a record. So if you, have a question real quick that you want me to answer? Otherwise, I'll be back. DL says only on the menu about eating undercooked food. Okay, only on the menu about eating undercooked food. Thanks for that, DL. Signs about raw food. And I know like some states, like all your seaboard states require you to post if, you know, about shellfish. You know, if you have shellfish allergies, or we sell raw, you know, eating raw oysters can cause your third eye to grow out of your back of your head or something. Bill says we sold peanut butter cookies and did have signage. That's interesting. I guess if I was serving, you know, peanut butter cookies, it'd be easy to, because it's not going to take away. I'm saying peanut butter cookies for sale. Well, that should be the obvious giveaway to have peanuts in them. But you could put beware of peanuts, you know, under it. What's Dirty Water Hot Dogs? Carl Baker, great question, brother. Dirty Water Hot Dogs, if most of us boil dogs, okay, not all of us, but most of us, boil first. Some of us hold it in the water. I do. I hold it in the water. I turn my fire off. It holds there. It stays nice and hot. But sometimes the water can sap out the flavor from the dog. So it's often good to start with non-chlorinated water because that will help keep the color the same way it's supposed to be on the dog. But even just the water boiling, you'll see the water get greasy, and that's where the term dirty water dog came from, because they sat in that water and the water got more and more nasty looking. Tastes delicious though. Okay. We should bottle it and sell it. Dirty water, hot dog, dirty hot dog water or something. But anyway, I've been teaching for years. Go ahead and spice up your water. Throw a couple onions in there. Throw a beef bouillon cube or a chicken cube, or maybe some people put some peppers in theirs now. I've heard some crazy stuff. Since I've been teaching this, I have heard some crazy stuff that was funny. I'm talking funny. That people have put in there. But you can put a can of beer in there. The yeast in the beer and all that stuff, the stuff, the hops, make it taste good. So we've put beer in the water. I always put beer in my water. Beef bouillon cube, I already said. So that's what is dirty water dogs. That's how that came about. I probably went a little too long on that one. You're welcome. Let's see. Some people ask for no bun because of gluten, but I tell them to throw away the bun because the dog is hot to hold in the foil. That's a good thing. And you can buy gluten-free buns now. Okay, you can buy gluten-free buns. If you're getting a lot of call for that, you may want to think about adding. You know, you might want to start with a pack, and then if you run out and say, oh, it's sold out, and then tomorrow bring two packs, you know, and kind of try that out. Some of your cheaper hot dogs have, filler, flour and stuff in them, which has gluten. So keep that in mind. If you're buying a really, really cheap dog, I don't suggest the real cheap dogs. Let's see. Oh yeah, Kenny. You know what? We did a blog article about that. I wonder if I can find that and post it up here. Kenny says, try hot dogs on a stick. We have vendors selling only on a stick. They serve the hot dogs on a stick. Footlongs, regular ones, quarter pounders on a stick. And they do them up cool how they do this. And so if you go look at learnhotdogs.com and just type in the search box, stick, maybe to find it by stick. Let's see. I'm at just over broke. Just dropped in to say hello, everyone. Peace and bacon grease. I like that. Neil, peace and bacon grease. I've got veggie dogs, never opened them, had them for months. You know what? I've tried some veggie dogs. I was just testing stuff out. And then I had a vendor send me some, I think from Washington State. And he said, oh, you got to try these, Ben. They're the best. No, they weren't. Maybe the best veggie dog. But I'm not going to try a bunch of veggie dogs to form an opinion whether those were the best. But some people like that stuff. I've got a daughter that's vegan and she eats all that, you know, veggie stuff. And I don't have a problem with vegetables. I just don't want my meat. I let my meat products, while they're alive, eat vegetables. And then I eat them, thereby vicariously I am getting hooked up with some vegetables. Read what's in them, veggie dogs. I haven't. Many cheap dogs come out real salty, but you have to test that stuff. There's some people, like here in East Tennessee, people love freaking salty dogs. I mean, they love them. That's why my wife likes those cheap dogs. They're salty, salty. She likes that. Some people just love it. I'm not real crazy about it. I do premium. I buy Johnsonville brats. Love the flavor. They are great. Johnsonville brats are good. Brats aren't as popular in the South. Okay. The further north you get, the more popular brats get. I love brats. I took some the other day raw and stuffed them, put garlic, roasted garlic, cherries, raw cherries. Okay. I took out the seed or the pit and then cheese. Okay. Five cheese, Mexican cheese, wrapped them in bacon and grilled them suckers. They were delicious. Yeah, Michael says, I have customers that add salt and pepper to their dogs, carry salt and pepper on the cart. always carry salt and pepper. You can buy a box, you know, like with, it's a little box like this. It's like a million packs of salt and pepper, the little joint packs. You can buy those cheap. You can get them at Amazon. You can get them at Katom, KATOM.com, WebsterAuntStore.com. You can buy that stuff cheap and have them, give them out, or you can keep some salt shakers around. I'm from the Caribbean, Trinidad and Tobago. It suits our tropical taste buds. I'm with you. I'm glad you're here. I haven't seen you in a while. Because you've been here before and then you weren't here. Let's see. Neil says, has Johnsonville brought with Aldi label for less? Yes. Aldi's, you know, that German grocery store. And you can get them cheaper because Aldi had Johnsonville private label for them. And just so you know, a lot of companies do private label. Y'all remember those pop opens I showed you a couple weeks ago? That as soon as you put them in hot water or put them on a grill, they're made to pop open. But they were unbelievably good dogs. Some of the best hot dog I have ever tasted in my life, just without anything added to it, just the dog, you know, and bread. And those were really, really good dogs. They private label that company that I told you about, Zweigels or something, Zweigels. They private label, so you could have them private labeled for you. Michael says, steal your wife's salt and pepper shaker. That's a good one. And that's true. You can. I'm looking. I don't think I have anything else. I appreciate y'all. I'm glad we did this, and I'm glad we did it fairly quick. But I'll be back tomorrow. Y'all be watching. I don't know what time I'll do it, but I've got a buttload of stuff to catch up with. But I will get that done, and I'll do it live, and I'll show you there these hot dog sliders. You're going to freaking love them. I mean, that just one, they're cute. Plus, if you were serving them, you'd be unique as heck, and your steak can't deny you serving them. Love it. How do you brick a flat top? How do you brick it? Well, I don't know what you mean, Dave. Are you talking about those bricks to clean? Is that what you're talking about? Those they're called grill bricks or griddle bricks. I've just heated mine up with hot water, but I've never used the brick. But I was at a vendor one time, and he had one of those pads, like you see at a restaurant, which had the brick on the bottom, I guess. I'm sorry, Josh, but you can always just rewind, Josh. Good evening, all. Got to get ready. Prep time. I understand. I appreciate y'all a bunch. I hope y'all have a good evening. I'll see you tomorrow.